You want the best for your car? You already watch our tutorials.
So the best place for the best deal is to buy from the Mr. Auto app.
Easy, fast, and with better prices than on the website.
You will find the bulk control arms used in the video exclusively on the Mr. Auto website and through the link in the description. Turn your engine off, pull up the handbrake, pull on the bonnet release lever and open the bonnet. To remove the front silent block's retaining screw, you need to remove many elements. Using a Phillips screwdriver, unscrew the two upper bumper retaining screws on either side of the bonnet release lever. Then remove the two plastic rivets using a pry bar. Using a multi-bit screwdriver and a T27 Torx bit, unscrew the two upper bumper retaining screws located next to the headlights. Loosen the stud bolts on the front wheels. Lift the front of the vehicle. We strongly suggest watching the tutorial Raising Your Vehicle Safely before carrying out this step. Place the vehicle on the axle stands. You must remove the wheels in order to change the control arms on your vehicle. This will give you full access to the suspension system. Don't forget to slide the wheels under the vehicle. Using a multi-bit screwdriver and a T27 Torx bit, unscrew the two screws holding the mudguard to the bumper. Then unscrew the screw holding the bumper to the fender using the same tools. You can now repeat the operation on the other side. Using a Phillips screwdriver, unscrew the four lower bumper retaining screws. Then remove the four plastic rivets using a pry bar. Unclip the edge of the bumper. Before removing it, remember to disconnect the two daytime running light power supplies. You can now remove the bumper. Brush the screws holding the bumper reinforcing bar to the side rail and spray them with penetrating oil. Using a socket wrench and a 15mm socket, unscrew the four retaining screws. Using a socket wrench and a 15mm socket, unscrew the two screws holding the metal plate. Then remove it. Brush the two bolts holding the side rail and spray them with penetrating oil. Remove them using a socket wrench and an E18 Torx socket. Then remove the side rail. You now have access to the screw holding the front silent block of the control arm. Turn the disc inwards. This will facilitate the process. Brush the bolt holding the suspension ball joint and spray it with penetrating oil. Using a socket wrench and a 17mm socket, unscrew the suspension bolt joint retaining nut. Then remove the screw. You can use a pin punch to help you remove it. Next, insert a crowbar resting on the underbody in order to pry and disengage the suspension bolt joint from the stub axle. Unscrew the screw holding the front silent block of the control arm using a socket wrench and an E18 Torx socket. Do the same with the rear retaining screw, blocking the rotation of the nut using an 18mm spanner. Then remove the screw. You can now remove the control arm by pulling on it and moving back and forth.
All parts used in this tutorial are supplied by our trusted partners. These partners also help us create as many video tutorials as possible. Check them out in the description below.
You will find the bulk parts and products used in the video on the Mr. Auto site and in the link in the description. Take the new control arm. Start by brushing and lubricating the location of the control arm silent blocks to facilitate the installation. Put the new control arm in place. You can use a screwdriver to align the control arms and screw it back in with more ease until it makes contact. Put the front silent block retaining screw back in place and roughly screw it back on. Replace the control arm ball joint in the steering knuckle. Then screw the bolt back in. Finish off the tightening with a Torx wrench. In order not to damage the silent blocks, you need to tighten the front retaining bolts with the control arms in the vehicle on the ground position. So, lift the control arm with a jack. Remove the jack. Put the side rail back in place. Then screw the two bolts back on. Finish off the tightening with a Torx wrench. You can then put the metal plate back in place. Then screw it back in. Screw the four side rail retaining screws back on. Put the bumper back in place. First, reconnecting the power supply to the daytime running lights. Tighten the screw holding the bumper to the fender. Tighten the two screws holding the mudguard to the bumper. Tighten the four lower bumper retaining screws. Then you will be able to put the wheels back on your vehicle. Put your car back on the ground and block the wheels properly. Tighten the four upper bumper retaining screws. Operation completed.
Hi, it's Theo from UseTool. I hope this video has helped you a lot in your car maintenance. We would be super grateful if you could spread the word so that we can produce even more tutorials. Simply give us a like, a comment, and hit that subscribe button. It really helps us boost the channel and help the whole community. Thanks a lot and have a great one.